stand just off it, I think.
Has he been operated remotely?
Yeah, we can switch them remotely.
Yeah. So kind of
okay.
So you'll zoom in and out remotely?
No, just stay on that shot, so we can just kind of watch the three of you from there.
I'll plant myself on the line.
Yeah.
Right.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Welcome to this very special occasion. Can I ask you please all to stand as we await the entrance of the bride? Thank you. Nothing like a wedding, is there? Absolutely nothing like it. It's an awesome occasion. I want to welcome you on behalf of both families, on the church family here, the church family in Glossop. This is a natural family joining and a spiritual family joining. This is a great occasion. So we're delighted you've been able to join us. And we want to welcome our YouTube watchers. This is going live on YouTube channel to Canada and to America and to various people. So if you see people waving at the cameras, think, what are they doing? They're waving to friends and relatives who weren't able to be here today. So wonderful to have you all here. While we're all standing, we're going to take the opportunity to sing the first hymn that's on your order of service. So let's sing, and I'll hand to Joy and Alan, who will lead us. Thanks.
Whatever may pass, I'm going.
Thank you. Well, we've come together in the presence of God today to witness the marriage of Mark and Helen. We're going to ask his blessing on them, and we're all here to share in their joy. You know, there's something special about being involved in the wedding of someone you've known since they were born, and that's how I know Mark, close family friend. And what a joy to be part of his wedding today. Helen, I don't know much at all yet, but I just take Mark's word for it. She's an awesome girl. It's God, that's right. So it's awesome to be able to celebrate this union together. You know, it's good at times like this to refresh our mind of what the scripture says about marriage. So it says it's a gift of God in creation, a means of his grace. It's a holy mystery in which a man and a woman become one flesh. And we believe that as the man and woman give themselves unconditionally to each other, it's just a picture of a more divine kind of love, that between Christ and his church. And because you both love Jesus and are part of your church, we know that means something special to you guys. Marriage is given that husband and wife will comfort, help each other, living faithfully together through whatever life throws at them. It's given that so with delight and tenderness they can raise children as God blesses them and gives an opportunity. It's given so that we can support each other, stand together, and play our part in the community as not just a nuclear family, but part of the family of God. So we believe it's a way of life all should honor, that all should respect, and that's why we are celebrating marriage itself as well as this union in this wedding today. So this is the way of life created and hallowed by God that Mark and Helen are now going to begin. They're each going to give their consent. They'll join hands and exchange vows. And as a token of those vows, they're each going to give and receive a ring. So on this, their wedding day, we pray with them that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their life together. But first I'm required to ask, if anyone present knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry, to declare it now, please. That's good. The expected silence. Okay, Mark, repeat after me, please. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Mark Joseph Silvers.
Why I, Mark Joseph Silvers.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Helen Elizabeth Cole.
To Helen Elizabeth Cole.
Helen. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Helen Elizabeth Cole.
Why I, Helen Elizabeth Cole.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Mark Joseph Silvers.
Mark Joseph Silvers.
So Mark, will you take Helen to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her? And forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I will.
And Helen, will you take Mark to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and submit to him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Wonderful. So who gives this woman to be married?
I do.
Thank you. Thanks, Alistair. Bless you. Be seated. Okay, let's make this marriage. Mark, I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Mark Joseph Silvers.
To witness that I, Mark Joseph Silvers.
Do take you, Helen Elizabeth Cole.
Do take you, Helen Elizabeth Cole.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love, cherish and serve,
to love, cherish and serve,
until death parts us,
until death parts us,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Fabulous. Helen. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Helen Elizabeth Cole,
to witness that I, Helen Elizabeth Cole,
do take you, Mark Joseph Silvers,
do take you, Mark Joseph Silvers,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love, cherish and obey,
to love, cherish and obey,
until death parts us,
until death parts us,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow,
this is my solemn vow.
Fabulous. Well, as a token of the vows that Mark and Helen had just made today, they're each going to give and receive a ring from the other. If we can have the rings, please, best man. Best man. Thank you. Excellent. Let's just pray together, shall we? Heavenly Father, right at the start of this union, we command your blessing upon it. Lord, I thank you that you've heard the vows that have been exchanged. You heard where they came from. They didn't come from their heads, they came from their hearts. And Lord, I just ask that the meaning and the love that they share, expressed in these vows, now will be remembered forever through the token of these rings. Lord, let the unending band of gold be a symbol to them of unending love, unending friendship, and an unending relationship together in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Little one.
Sorry.
There we go. Whoops.
Thank you.
Thank you. These things happen? Okay. I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love and devotion to you.
As a symbol of my love and devotion to you.
All that I am, I give you.
All that I am, I give you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Within the love of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Fabulous. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and devotion to you.
As a symbol of my love and devotion to you.
All that I am, I give you.
All that I am, I give you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Within the love of our Lord Jesus Christ.
There we go. Awesome. So in the presence of God, before you as a congregation, Mark and Helen have given their consent and made their marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring. Therefore, it's my great privilege to proclaim they are husband and wife. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may kiss your bride, sir. We pray that that which God has joined, no man will divide. Amen?
Amen?
Awesome. I'd like to invite you all to stand again and to join us for the second song on your order of service in this moment of great celebration. Thanks, guys.
Your singing is absolutely so marvellous. I can't actually hear the keyboard, so I'm just wondering if I could have the volume up. It's you two singing, isn't it? It's marvellous. Marvellous.
We're wasting our production.
I want to praise the wonders of your
you be seated. Wonderful. Well, I'd now like to invite Edward to come and to share a poem with the bride and the groom. Thank you.
Let me not to the marriage of true minds admit impediments. Love is not love which alters when it alteration finds, or bends with the remover to remove. Oh no, it is an ever fixed mark that looks on tempests and is never shaken. It is the star to every wandering bark, whose worth's unknown, although his height be taken. Love's not time's fool, though rosy lips and cheeks within his bending sickle's compass come. Love alters not with his brief hours and weeks, but bears it out even to the edge of doom. If this be error and upon me be proved, I never writ, nor no man ever loved.
Wise words indeed. And we're going to hear a few more wise words now from Alistair, Helen's dad, who's going to come and share a few thoughts with you. Come on, Alistair. Thank you. You okay with that there? Thank you.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good. Well, it's a great occasion to be here today and to enjoy this wonderful celebration. And we can just feel a sense of God's presence here, blessing us and blessing the union of Helen and Mark together. I remember one day when, as a young lad, coming home from school at the time when the Beatles were just coming into stardom. And one of their early songs was a song, All You Need Is Love. Love is all you need. And it's a song that we can remember, and many of you will remember that the tremendous words of that song. And right at the very heart of all that we're doing here today is love. Because at the end of the day, when a couple get married, it's because they've fallen in love. Or that's supposed to be the idea. Somebody once said, you know, this, that a marriage used to be a contract, but today it's a 90-day option. The story is told of two guys, just like these two guys are best man. And they're in a pub. Which is something that they do on a fairly regular basis. And they are having a discussion together and talking about the pros and cons of marriage. And they had a mutual friend called Bill. And the conversation went something like this. You know, our Bill has been unlucky with both of his marriages. His first wife left him and his second wife won't. But, you know, the ingredients of a marriage relationship, personality, trust, physical attraction, mutual respect, and of course, love and mutual interests. Now, if you marry into the Cole family, you have to be interested in sport. Mark, as far as Helen's concerned, your prime motivation has to be on two fronts: films and hair. Okay, if you can sort of get your head around those sort of two situations, then you'll be fine. But you know, a service such as this would be remiss if we didn't just pause for a moment and reflect upon perhaps the greatest words that have ever been written that really talk about genuine love. And these words were written by the great man, the Apostle Paul, and we find them in the New Testament in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And I want to read a couple of sections from that amazing chapter. And Paul is speaking about the importance of love. And this is what he says. If I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, if I understand all of God's secret plans and possess all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor, and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it, but if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable and it keeps no record of being wrong. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. Prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless. But love will last forever. Now our knowledge is partial and incomplete, and even the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when a time of perfection comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. All that I know now is partial and incomplete. But then I will know everything completely, just as God knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Many of you will know that this great chapter is sandwiched in between two chapters where the Apostle Paul speaks of church ministry and spiritual gifts. But all of those things Paul is saying are meaningless and inconsequential if they are not motivated by this great language of love. Very quickly, two or three things this afternoon just to leave with you about love. First of all, it is indispensable. Paul here says, if I speak in the language of heaven and earth but don't love others, I'm just basically making a noise. And we can be involved in all kinds of activity. We can be involved in all kinds of Christian activities. We can even try and make success of the marriage relationship. But if foundational to that, there is not that love there, it will be meaningless. Love is the foundation upon which your marriage will be built. Firstly, a love of God. And which has already been pointed out, that Helen and Mark are beginning their married life together, committed to serving God together. I know, for example, that one of the things they committed to do every day of the week is to spend time together in reading the Bible and praying as a married couple. That is building a strong foundation into their marriage. Love is invaluable. Paul here says it is patient. It is kind. It's not jealous or boastful. Does not, now listen to this, Mark, it does not demand its own way. So what do you mean to be able to say to Helen every day of the week is simply two words: yes, dear. And you'll be fine. You'll be fine. Keeps no record of wrongs. That's an interesting one, isn't it? Keeps no record of wrongs, never gives up or loses faith, endures through every circumstance. Love is infallible. And the sort of love that we're talking about here, and the sort of love that we believe is going to cement this relationship together, it is the love that was demonstrated by our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, whose presence we're in today. And his whole life and ministry was motivated by love and compassion. We go back to our pub, and the conversation of these two gentlemen continues something like this. You know, every man needs a wife, because there are some things in life that you can't blame on the government. Think about that. I don't know whether that's fix-it or Brexit, but moving on very quickly. But just to summarise my thoughts today, Paul here says there are three things that will endure: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. And God will bless your relationship and establish it when right at its heart is the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. So in conclusion, we pray God's blessing upon your union, upon your relationship. We pray that right in the centre of your marriage will be the Lord Jesus Christ, and that he will be Lord in every situation. And we're going to just stand now, and I'm going to pray a prayer of blessing over Mark and Helen. I'm going to pray God's blessing upon them, that God will enrich them, and that they together may know the peace and the love and the joy that only our Lord Jesus Christ can give. Let's stand together as we pray. Our loving Heavenly Father, we come before you at this wonderful moment in our service today. And we just pause for a few seconds and we thank you for the amazing love that you have bestowed upon us. We thank you, Lord, that you have showed us that love in giving us your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And we pray your blessing upon Mark and Helen today. We ask you, Lord, that you will prosper them. We ask you, Lord, that you will strengthen them. We ask you, Lord, that you will protect them. We ask you, Lord, that right at the very heart of their marriage relationship may be your joy and your peace and your strength and your fellowship as they live together as husband and wife and as they serve you together. Helen and Mark, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
God bless you. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Alistair. You may all be seated. We just have to now complete the legal formalities, which are going to take place in a side room here, so you're going to be allowed to relax, chat a little, some music will be playing, chat amongst yourselves for about 5 minutes or so, and then we'll be back once those formalities are completed, okay? So sit tight, over to the guy, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for waiting. A couple of simple announcements just to on the practical front. Firstly, there'll be drinks available for you all as you leave this room. Please feel to spill into this area out here, out onto the balcony. It's a beautiful day. And just hang together a little while, get some photos. Those of you who are moving on to the reception, you need to be there at 5:45 at the very latest. But you can arrive any time you like before then. So I'd suggest sort of 5 onwards. Get yourself a drink, but 5:45 or you don't get fed, okay? Awesome. Well, let's be upstanding and let's greet our bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Mark Silvers.
Is it the look in your eyes, or is it this So what you wanna do? Let's just run, girl. If we wake up and you wanna break up, that's cool. No, I won't blame you. It was fun, girl. Don't say no, 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 no. Just say yeah, 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 yeah. And we'll go, 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 go. If you're ready, like I'm ready. It's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby, I think I wanna marry you. Is it the look in your eyes? Or is it this dancing juice? Who cares, baby? I think I wanna marry you. Just I think I want